vacation there. And from there, we're going up to Seattle. From Seattle, we're going up to north, up to Arlington. And from there, we're driving to Canada because, believe it or not, the cheapest tickets were from Vancouver, BC, rather than from Seattle. I guess we would prefer Seattle better, but the cheapest tickets won our hearts and our wallets too. So we're on the way to the church and looking forward to a good worship service. This church is our supporting church and we've never been there, so we're excited to actually meet some people there and get to know them. Hey, what are you eating? I'm sorry I caught you off guard. Oh, that looks good.
So you know all this. I'll just read them. It'll be a good reminder then. James and Bond.
All right, the church service is done, and we're headed over to Caleb's brother's house for dinner. We're excited to see the new place where he has just moved to. But the church service was great. We had a wonderful time meeting lots of new people, and the church is very unique. It has an English-speaking church meeting in the morning, and then Samoan church is meeting in early in the afternoon, and a Spanish-speaking church is meeting in the evening. So it's really, really a neat use of the building, and we see that God is really working great in that church. People are excited about the ministry, and the pastor is on fire for the Lord, so we're so glad that we were able to be a part of that. Okay, getting ready to go across the border. We have about 10 miles left.
Yeah.
What are you eating?
I don't know, some sort of artisan bread sandwich at McDonald's, yeah. Before we cross the border into Canada.
Our day is almost over. We are headed for the Canadian border, and we'll be there in about 15 minutes. But had a nice lunch with Caleb's brother and his apartment mate, and they made a very nice lunch for us. And then we had a meeting with a family that has been a long-time supporter of our ministry, and we were very thankful to get together with them. A very fun time, however, it was fairly brief because we had to leave. So right now we're getting a little sustenance and heading to Canada. Hopefully we'll cross the border with no problems. Good morning. We are in Vancouver and had a good night at an Airbnb, a very nice place, wouldn't you say?
Yeah, small, just, simple.
Yeah, just exactly what we needed. And this morning we are going to the Dutch.
Like
I don't know, something like this, a Dutch cafe. It's actually pretty late for breakfast, but we're going for lunch. No luggage storage for those who don't have tickets to the Canadian railway system. So we have to find another way. Almost looks like a story time. Caleb and I are walking in a very nice neighborhood. What is it called?
Shaughnessy.
Shaughnessy, and has lots of different styles of homes. Some of them are really nice and modern, and some of them are older. But the modern homes, they're mainly built in an older style, wouldn't you say?
Yeah.
To kind of try to keep with the neighborhood. So we're just enjoying wandering about, waiting for our flight this evening. After a long day of walking along some very pricey looking houses and streets, I came to the conclusion that it's very pretty to look at, but to maintain it is a totally different story. And
you need to buy it.
Well,
pay for it.
Yeah. To pay for it and to pay for maintenance. It's a lot of hard work, a lot of money that goes into it, and so I'm actually quite happy with the situation that we have, with the apartment that we have. Well, at least for now, it works well for us. What do you think?
Yeah.
Now we're having a bit of a snack at this Van Dusen Park. It's a very nice cafe here. Getting a little bit of a coffee charge, and then off to walk in again, and then back to the airport where we deposited our luggage, and then off to Chile. We're finally at the airport in Vancouver, and we just have very interesting Native American statues here. Very beautiful though, very nice to be able to sit here and just relax. Very pretty. Hola a todos. Estamos en Mexico, Mexico City. Estamos muy cansados, muy cansados. No, not casados, cansados. Anyway, we're practicing our Spanish. It's not going very well. It's so much easier to start speaking English, because most of the people here that work here at the airport know English, and they speak English to you when you speak English to them. We had a bit of a scare. We thought we lost our luggage, all of it, but we didn't, thankfully, and it's all good. It's all with us. It's very interesting. We're not used to, while traveling, having to go to a country where we transfer flights and then go through security, pick up our bags, and then deposit our bags again, and then check in for the next flight. So that was different, wasn't it?
It was kind of a big pain.
Yeah, well, what can you do? That was surprising, but now we know how it's done in Mexico. The flight was short, overnight, and hot, and we're very tired. We're looking forward to maybe sleeping on this flight to Santiago. Any words of wisdom that you have for us?
We found Starbucks here.
Oh, yes.
We got a Starbucks cup.
Yes, now we added to our collection. We have a cup of Mexico City and a cup of Mexico. So on the way back, we have a 10-12 hour layover. So we're really hoping to be able to go out into the city and see some sights. The theme in Benito Juarez Airport of the Mexico City is holes. The whole airport is built in this theme. Everything has little, it's like little portholes everywhere. cool. We arrived this morning and we thought we will not need jackets, but it was fairly cold. So we were thankful to not have given our jackets to be checked with the checked luggage.
All right, we're on the plane and I was really hoping to be able to see the mountain, Mount Aconcagua, when we get closer to Santiago. But look at this. I'm sitting next to absolutely no window. So anyway, there's a window next to me over here, but it's completely blue and I cannot see anything out of it. So I guess we'll just have to be happy with this. All right, we made it to Santiago. It's about 9.
Almost 10.
Almost 10 p.m. Didn't have any problems, had a wonderful flight. Everything went smoothly. Yeah. We're excited, and as you see, we don't have our coats anymore. It's about 20 degrees Celsius here, I would say.
Yeah, it's actually very comfortable, but definitely don't need coats.
Yeah, my two coats are not gonna serve me any purpose, so. Anyway, excited to be here, excited to get to know Nick and his family, missionaries here, and happy to see what's gonna happen.